it's Ash, and today I have here my Rebecca Minkoff and Purseforum collaboration handbag. This is called the Darcy. It's actually in the color black. I just received this yesterday, so I did a little unboxing, but today I'm going to share with you my review, plus give you some of my pros and cons. So please like this video if you love it, leave a comment or question below if you have one, and like always, subscribe if you want to see more. So let's get started. Let's begin with unboxing. I finally received my bag on March 11, 2013, and I actually had to pre-order this bag online for $395 at Nordstrom.com. And I pre-ordered this back in January 2013. Since then, it has sold out, and it's actually sold out within 1 month. And this is a limited edition piece, so it might not be reproduced or restocked. So you can add this to your wait list or wish list, and hopefully it'll come back. The Darcy is a collaborative bag designed between Rebecca Minkoff and Purseforum members. It actually took 1 year in the making because of numerous polls within the forum. Members actually got to vote in the polls, and the polls actually eventually helped inspire the name, design, and color of this very bag. The bag was finally revealed in September 2012 during New York Fashion Week. It is a bowler-style satchel with Italian black leather, pale gold hardware, and fringe zipper pulls. It has two short top handles, one top zipper, one front horizontal zipper, the Rebecca Minkoff signature flap, two vertical zippers, no feet, and side D-rings for attachable and adjustable shoulder straps. This handbag has black and white print lining with Rebecca Minkoff's name camouflaged within it. This lining is also an indication that it was made in the United States. The back of the Darcy card is the only indication of where this handbag was made, which is New York City. I have searched everywhere in the bag and I have not found any tags within the bag to actually indicate where it is made. The interior has one large zipper pocket, one small card slip pocket with the Rebecca Minkoff and Purseforum name embossed on the leather label, and two slip pockets on the opposite side, and they're pretty huge. The Darcy can be carried in your hands, on your shoulder, on the crook of your arm, or with the shoulder strap on your shoulder, or as a crossbody bag. This handbag is made from premium Italian leather and it feels smooth. It actually reminds me a lot of the Mini M.A.C leather. The leather on this handbag also has a really strong scent, so beware. The length of the Darcy varies from 12.5 to 16.5 inches. The width also varies from 6.5 to 5 inches. The top zipper is about 18 inches long. The zipper pulls are also the same as all of our other handbags, and they also feel very smooth and very easy to maneuver. Unlike the Mini M.A.C fringes, the fringes on the Darcy are not sewn, thus they can be removed to change the feel of the bag. The other odd thing about the zipper pulls was which side is facing up, the name or the pattern. How come there is no consistency? Alright, so my black Darcy only comes with one zipper pull on the top, and I actually thought there were going to be two like the runway model, but I'm looking with one. I'm so disappointed. It would look so good if there was two right in the middle. Onto the front zipper pocket, we have a gold plaque below the zipper with Rebecca Minkoff's name. Opening the zipper will reveal the same lining as the interior. This pocket measures out to be 7.5 inches long and 4.75 inches high. You can most definitely fit any of your iPhones, smartphones in here, or any of your keys, cards, whatever you need. Onto the flap side of the bag, we have a large flap at 9 inches long. It's the signature Rebecca Minkoff flap design, also seen in the Mini Morning After Clutch. There are two vertical zippers, and their opening is about 5 inches. The flap on this bag has no function except for aesthetics and brand recognition. Each vertical zipper opens into its own separate pocket with the same interior lining. The two pockets don't ever touch each other because they're actually two separate ones and they're really small. I actually wish that they had made this just one huge pocket with two openings because it would be so much more cooler. You cannot fit your iPhone, although I tried, but you can put smaller items like your chapstick or if you have
like an apartment key or a credit card or something that you just want to put in there really easily, you could do that. This bag has two top handles made out of leather, and they look like they were crafted very well. They also feel pretty hard and very sturdy. I have one problem with these handles, and it has to be the way the ends were designed. When the handles are sitting up, they leave a dent or an impression on the leather. I don't know if you guys could see that, but this bag is only one day old, and the handles already look like they're digging into the leather, which is pretty bad. Below the ends of each strap, there's also a small D-ring that protrudes out, which is great for the shoulder strap. This handbag also has no feet, which I don't understand because I actually think that all of the other Rebecca Minkoff handbags or satchel style bags do have feet. Having feet would actually really help prevent any scratches or stains on this leather, and you can actually see a couple of scratch marks already, so I don't know. Shoulder straps also come with this handbag, and these are adjustable buckle belt style straps. The strap has a dog leash clasp at the ends, and this can allow the strap to be attached to the thick D-ring that's on the handbag. The clasps are really round in shape, and so is the knob, which is a lot different from what I've seen in the Mini M.A.C, which is more of like a pointier shape. Here is a close-up shot of the buckle. I'm going to demonstrate how to actually adjust this buckle, and it's actually really easy, and the leather feels really tight on this little edge right here, and I love that. Now, I did find one problem with the clasp or D-ring. I'm not sure whose problem it is, but it's very hard to maneuver the opening of the clasp through the D-ring because it's so thick. It is a really tight fit, but I actually love the look of the clasp on the side of the handbag. Alright, so this bag also has four little D-rings that are right next to the strap or right below them, and they are great to actually apply this clasp because they're a little bit more smaller and it makes it more easier to put the clasp on and off of it. And it's probably because it has more space between the opening. Alright, so I'm going to use my other strap from my Mini M.A.C and try to attach this to the rings, and it fits that one just perfectly, but the bottom one is a little bit too thick. It hooks onto it, but it will not work. I think when you attach the shoulder strap to the bag, it actually looks really beautiful, but if you were to actually move the strap to its highest setting or closest to the buckle, and you have that extra part just flapping around, it looks super hideous and super ugly, especially when you're going to put it down to the ground and you're just going to carry it in the crook of your arm. I mean, just look at how nasty that looks. This bag does seem to flip over, but that's because the bag is empty. When it's full, it doesn't do this at all. Now let's move on to the interior of this bag. This bag has a really large opening, which I absolutely love about it. On our first side of the interior pockets, we have two slip pockets that are about 4 inches wide and 4.5 inches tall. They have a large opening, which is great for your camera, keys, phones, pins, lip gloss, whatever. On the opposite side, there is one large zipper pocket with a Rebecca Minkoff zipper pull. This zipper is about 8 inches long. In the front of that, there is a small pocket with a Rebecca Minkoff and Purseforum embossed label. This pocket is about 4.5 inches long, which is good for your authentication cards or any of your business cards that you might have. The interior lining is attached perfectly well into the edges of this bag. Although it looks good now, there will be problems in the future because this lining is not sewn together, but glued. What is this? Alright, so I'm going to stuff my Mini M.A.C into this Darcy and it fits perfectly well. Here's a comparison of my Delightful PM and the Darcy next to each other. I'm going to leave you now with this last video clip of me stuffing this bag with all of my accessories, my wallet, my sunglasses case, my phone, keys, you know, the whole shenanigans shebang. And this bag fits everything perfectly. I'm not sure if it'll fit your iPads or whatever because I don't have one, but here it is. Flip purses are the new style.